Hello students, I am Jnaneshwara TN. In the previous session, we had discussed the main characters of the short story Living or Dead. In this session, let us discuss the main themes of the story. The learning objective of this session is to help you to analyze the story. After watching this video, you will justify the title of the story, you will discuss the style of the story, you will identify the symbols used in the story, you will discuss the themes of the story. Let us recall what we have learnt in the previous session. Kadambini, a widow, is considered dead even though she is alive. Sharada Shankar, the zamindar, is the brother-in-law of Kadambini. Satish, Sharada Shankar's son, has been fostered by Kadambini. Jogmaya is Kadambini's childhood friend and Sripati is her husband. The title of the story is Living or the Dead. The widow is, as the title suggests, both living and dead, or perhaps neither living nor dead. She does not belong to the world of the living, and yet she is trapped there as a lonely and inauspicious being. A widow is more dead than alive to the rest of the world in a Hindu society. If we examine the style of the story written in the simplest of words, it is a satire on society. Let us explore the symbols Tagore has used in this story. Ghost. In this story, the widow's existence is compared to that of a ghost, a deceased person's spirit. Ordinarily becomes a ghost before it moves on to rebirth. During this transitional stage, the ghost maintains attachments to its previous life in the world, yearning for food and attention from former relatives and loved ones until the sequence of funeral rites finally cuts these attachments. The widow similarly is in a transitional state between life and death, but for an indefinite prolonged period. Like ghosts, widows cannot fully participate in household life. Like ghosts, they are frightening and cause misfortune. Symbolic death. One night, Kadambini dies suddenly. Four Brahmin servants take her body to burning ground for cremation. In the absence of Brahmin servants, she awakens alone. She had not in fact died, but had only been temporarily unconscious. Seeing the cremation ground around her in the dead of the night, she believes that she has died and that she is now a ghost. Here the death is symbolic because as a widow, Kadambini was more dead than alive. Widows are not allowed in any ritual in Hindu society. Ink pot. When Kadambini became faint and fell on the bed, everything was black, as when an ink pot is upset over an exercise book. Kadambini's memory and consciousness in a moment became formless. Let us discover the themes in the story. Superstition. When the bed shook slightly, the Brahmin servants Vidu and Banamali fancied that, as if the dead body had turned on its side, both of them trembled and began muttering Ram Ram. In a moment, the watchers leapt out of the hut and raced for the village. After conscious return, Kadambini thought she was no member of earthly society. Surely she was a creature of horror, of ill omen, her own ghost. Illusion. When conscious returned, Kadambini thought the lonely dark place was the house of Yama. She reflected, I am dead. I have left the kingdom of the living. I am my own ghost. She felt that she had marvelous strength, endless freedom. She could do what she liked, go where she pleased. While staying at her friend's house at the dead of night, when alone in her room, she screamed. In the evening, when she saw her shadow in the lamplight, her whole body shook. Alienation. While staying in Jogmaya's house, Kadambini would think she has her husband and her work. She lives in a world far away from mine. She shares affection and duty with the people of the world. I am an empty shadow. She is among the living. I am an eternity. Surely she was no member of earthly society. Bindings of Maya. When Kadambini returns to her in-law's home, her brother-in-law Sharda Shankar beseeches her to cut all the bindings of her Maya for the world. He pleads, when you have taken leave of samsara, then go ahead and tear open your bindings of Maya. We will perform all the funeral rites. Sharda Shankar heltane, ನೀನು ಮಾಯಾ ಬಂಧನವನ್ನು ಕಡಿದುಕೋ, ನೀನು ಈ ಪ್ರಪಂಚವನ್ನು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೋಗಿದ್ದೀಯಾ, ನಾವು ನಿನಗೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ ಅಂತ್ಯ ಸಂಸ್ಕಾರಗಳನ್ನು ನೆರವೇರಿಸ್ತೀವಿ, ನೀನು ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಈ ಮಾಯಾ ಬಂಧನದಿಂದ ಕಳಚಿಕೋ ಅಂತ ಆಕೆಯನ್ನು ಬೇಡಿಕೊಳ್ತಾನೆ. ವಿಡೋಹುಡ್. ಟ್ಯಾಗೋರ್ ಸಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಡೋಹುಡ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಸೋಬರಿಂಗ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಸ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ created no rituals that could release the widow from her liminal condition. Tagore en heltare andre ee vaidhavyadinda bidugade honduva yagavannu kuda nama samaja roopisilla. So Kadambini finally kills herself, the only act that can free her from her terrible equivocal condition as a ghost-like widow. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಕಾದಂಬಿನಿ ಈ ಒಂದು ಭೂತದ ರೀತಿಯ ವೈಧವ್ಯದಿಂದ ಬಿಡುಗಡೆ ಹೊಂದೋದಕ್ಕೆ ತನಗಿರೋ ಒಂದೇ ದಾರಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಸಾವು ಅಂತ ತನ್ನನ್ನು ತಾನೇ ಕೊಂದುಕೊಳ್ತಾಳೆ. ದ ಮೊಮೆಂಟ್ ಅ ವುಮನ್ಸ್ ಹಸ್ಬೆಂಡ್ ಡೈಸ್, ಶಿ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡಿಕ್ಲೇರ್ಡ್ ಹಾಫ್ ಡೆಡ್. ಒಬ್ಬ ಮಹಿಳೆಯ ಗಂಡ ಸತ್ತ ಮರುಕ್ಷಣವೇ ಆಕೆ ಅರ್ಧ ಸತ್ತ ಹಾಗೆ. She becomes a burden, useful only as a servant, and is treated as a lifeless item which can be thrown out. Aake ondu hore anta anustale ganda satta nantara aakeyanna obba sevakiyagi ashte upayogisabahudu annuva reetiyalli avala paristhiti irthade. Avalu ontari ನಿರ್ಜೀವ ವಸ್ತುವಿನ ಹಾಗೆ ಭಾವಿಸಲ್ಪಡ್ತಾಳೆ, ಹೊರಗೆ ಎಸೆಯಬಹುದಾದ ಒಂದು ನಿರ್ಜೀವ ವಸ್ತುವಿನ ಹಾಗೆ ಅವಳ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಪ್ಲೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ವುಮನ್. ಕಾದಂಬಿನಿ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ವಿಡೋ. ಶಿ ಈವನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ನೋ ಕಿನ್ಸ್ಮೆನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಫಾದರ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ. ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಅನದರ್ ಆಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಡೈಡ್. Death also proves illusory for Kadambini, who never get anything easily in life. She becomes a living dead with no house and no companions. She desperately tries to evade herself from human touch as she considers herself a ghost. The story exposes the insensitivity of fellow human beings in ignoring a living woman but showing reverence to the dead ones, especially when they are supposed to have become ghosts. ಈ ಕತೆ ತನ್ನ ಸುತ್ತ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಜನ ಒಬ್ಬ ಜೀವಂತ ಮಹಿಳೆಯನ್ನು ಉದಾಸೀನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಆದರೆ ಸತ್ತು ಹೋಗಿರೋರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ವಿಶೇಷವಾಗಿ ಭೂತ ಅಥವಾ ದೆವ್ವ ಆಗಿರೋರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಗೌರವವನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾರೆ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನು ಈ ಕತೆ ಹೇಳ್ತದೆ. ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಶಿಪ್. ದೋ ಕಾದಂಬಿನಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಜೋಗ್ಮಾಯ ವರ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ಹುಡ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಮೆಟ್ ಈಚ್ ಅದರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಟೈಮ್, ಬಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಟು ಟೈಮ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್ಡ್ ಲೆಟರ್ಸ್. ಜೋಗ್ಮಾಯ ವಾಸ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಟು ಸೀ ಹರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಅ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಗ್ಯಾಪ್. ಕಾದಂಬಿನಿ ವಿಶಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಅ ಸರ್ವೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಹರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಹೌಸ್, ಬಟ್ ಜೋಗ್ಮಾಯ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಟ್ರೀಟ್ ಹರ್ ಸೋ. Motherly love. The story Living or Dead explores the mother-son-like relationship of a widow with the son of her brother-in-law. Kadambini was childless, but her brother-in-law Sharada Shankar's son was an apple of her eyes. As his mother was ill for a long time, she looked after the child as if he was her own son. All the widow's thwarted love went out towards this little child. When Kadambini returned her in-law's house, she felt only that she wanted to see her child again. Let us recapitulate what we have learnt in this session. The story, The Living or Dead, is written in the simplest of words. Death is symbolic here because as a widow, Kadambini was more dead than alive. Illusion, alienation, widowhood, friendship and motherly love are the important themes in the story. Insensitivity of the society towards widows is depicted in this story. Now let me check your understanding. I will ask some multiple choice questions. Try to answer the questions. Question number 1. Kadambini thought she was option A, no member of earthly society, option B, a creature of horror, option C, her own ghost, option D, all the above. Yes, you are correct. The correct answer is option D, all the above. Question number 2. When conscious returned, Kadambini thought the lonely dark place was option A, the house of Yama, option B, the house of her in-laws, option C, the house of Jogmaya, option D, the house of her father. Yes, you are correct. The correct option is option A, the house of Yama. Question number 3. Kadambini felt that she had option A, marvelous strength, option B, endless freedom, option C, both option A and option B, option D, neither option A nor option B. Yes, you are correct. The correct answer is option C, both A and B. Question number 4. Kadambini and Jogmaya were option A, childhood friends, option B, sisters, option C, sister-in-laws, option D, enemies. Yes, you are correct. The correct answer is option A, childhood friends. Question number 5. Kadambini wishes to be dash in her friend's house. Option A, a servant. Option B, a cook. Option C, a guest. Option D, sweeper. Yes, you are correct. The correct answer is option A, a servant. This is the list of websites I have referred. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.